Welcome, beloved viewers, to our channel. Today, we're embarking on a transformative journey that touches the very core of our existence, fear, an emotion that can hold us captive, rob us of our joys, and paralyze our progress. But as followers of Christ, we possess a secret weapon, a divine antidote against fear's grip. Join us as we unravel the power of courage and faith, and uncover the Christian's ultimate tool to conquer fear. Understanding the power of overcoming fear. Hey there, friends. It's truly wonderful to have you with us today. Let's kick things off by delving into the very essence of fear. It's like a shadow that follows us, affecting our choices, relationships, and dreams. But recognizing fear's impact is the first step towards overcoming it. For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. 2 Timothy 1-7, NIV. This verse emphasizes the idea that fear is not from God, and His Spirit empowers us to overcome it with love, power, and self-discipline. It aligns well with the theme of recognizing fear's impact and taking steps to overcome it. Fear takes on many forms, from the mundane to the profound. It can shroud us in anxiety, hinder growth, and steal our peace. But here's the remarkable part. Fear is not our destiny. It's a challenge we can conquer, and our faith is the key. The Christian's advantage. Now, let's journey deeper into our Christian advantage. In a world marred by uncertainty and trials, being a follower of Christ provides us with an unparalleled advantage, a source of strength and resilience that empowers us to face any situation. Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in Him. They will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when heat comes. Its leaves are always green. It has no worries in a year of drought and never fails to bear fruit. Jeremiah 17:7-8, NIV. At the heart of our advantage lies the sovereignty and power of God. It's a truth that shapes our worldview and extends His authority over all creation. Our God is not just an observer. He's orchestrating events for our good. Trusting in His ability to turn things around is a game changer. When life's storms rage, we rely on a God who can transform challenges into opportunities. It's a shift in perspective that empowers us to walk with unwavering faith. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose. Romans 8:28, NIV. This verse speaks directly to the concept of God's sovereignty and His ability to work things for our good, even in the midst of challenges and storms. It aligns well with the idea that trusting in God's ability to turn things around is a game changer and empowers us to walk with unwavering faith. Trusting God and overcoming doubt. Moving on, we encounter a critical juncture. Trusting God and overcoming doubt. It's a crucial aspect of our Christian journey as we navigate through a world often built on self-sufficiency. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do. James 1-6, NIV. This verse underscores the importance of faith and trust in God while warning against doubt, as doubt can lead to instability in our journey of faith. Placing trust solely in ourselves can lead to disappointment and emptiness. Our faith points us beyond the transient treasures of this world and redirects our focus toward eternal promises. Prayer becomes our lifeline, a direct line of communication with our Heavenly Father. Through prayer, we surrender our anxieties, knowing that God's compassion and intervention are ever present. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to Him, and He will make your paths straight. Proverbs 3-5-6, NIV. This verse reinforces the idea of placing trust in God rather than solely in ourselves, and it encourages us to acknowledge God's guidance in all aspects of our lives. Patience and faith in God's timing. Now let's explore the beautiful dance of patience and faith in God's timing. It's in our moments of waiting that our faith is tested and our resolve is strengthened. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Isaiah 40:31, NIV. This verse beautifully captures the essence of waiting on the Lord, gaining strength through patience, and having faith in His perfect timing. The stories of those who came before us, like Abraham and Joseph, serve as a beacon of hope. Their unwavering faith and patient endurance remind us that God's timing is always perfect. But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like a thousand years, and a thousand years are like a day. The Lord is not slow in keeping His promise, as some understand slowness. Instead, He is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. 2 Peter 3:8-9. The victory of living fearlessly. And now, my dear friends, we arrive at the pinnacle of our journey, the victory of living fearlessly, embracing our faith, relying on God's strength, and conquering fear. These are the keys to unlocking a life of purpose and joy. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Psalm 27:1, NIV. This verse beautifully captures the essence of living fearlessly by relying on the strength and protection of the Lord. It emphasizes the idea that with God by our side, there is no need to fear anything. Together, we can encourage one another to walk this path of courage, where fear loses its grip and faith becomes our guiding light. As we conclude this extraordinary journey, may we carry these truths deep within our hearts. Join us in the comments below as we continue this uplifting conversation. Share your thoughts, your experiences, and let's stand united against fear's grip. Until next time, dear friends, walk in faith, live fearlessly, and let your light shine brightly in a world that craves hope.